I believe I become the intent how of the firm because probably because we do something in the past 20 years. First of all, 20 years ago, internet just got success in United States, some country. But, in China, we get some information. This is a very useful facilities for education, research, for the communication. So I development, of course, leading my team. First internet backbone in China, we call CERNET, China Education and Research Network. This is the first backbone of China internet. This backbone reached 8 major cities, across all of the Chinese major places. So we use very low speed communication line, just 64 kilobit per second. We connect about 100 universities to provide internet access to him. Yeah, this is a very good question for me, because in the past more than 20 years, I do some job, but it's meet a lot of challenges, many kinds of challenges. But I believe that maybe two of them is very important or maybe difficult for me. First of all, we try something first. We never try before, like four kinds of works, but never tried before. But it's the first time to try. We don't know what happened. This is a big challenge. If you know what happened in the future, this is sometimes is dangerous. So secondly, you know, networking the things need to coordinate by many university and many institutions to work together. This is networking. So otherwise you don't need to work together. This is, you have to work together. So you need to coordinate different university, different people work together. This is a big challenge. Sometimes people have this opinion, another people have another opinion. They cannot get a consensus. This is difficult for us. So this is, remember, this is the two big challenges to me in the past 20 years. Yeah, I think we meet a lot of the important people for us, for me. But in the beginning, in the past more than 20 years, we meet very good, how to say, a very good boss from university, from the Minister of Education. So you need money, you need to get support from him. So if the boss is smart, is very powerful, very understanding you, that's very important. I meet a very good boss from the Minister of Education and the State Planning Commission in China. We discuss with him why internet is important for China, for outside of China. So they understand. After they understand, they give you fairly support and financial support. So that's very, very important. Understand each other is important. So this is first several important people. Secondly is the colleague. Some people, several people, work together with me, so every day. So like Professor Xin Li is my colleague before started 20 years. We teamed in the beginning just 6 people, a very small group. this is the kernel group of people. We work together so far. Conquered the internet, they provide good infrastructure for the human. Very useful, very important for him. But the, you know, the internet design in the 40 years ago, some protocols. So the people who designed the concrete internet, they never know internet have today. The very big, huge scale, and so many people connect to each other. Also, so many devices connect each other. So application is so many kinds of. In the beginning, just the email, just the FTP, very simple application. Right now, the very rich applications. So for internet designer, they never know what happened today. So internet have so many challenges. Basically, it's five challenges important for internet, concrete internet. First of all, it's a scale. People hope internet bigger and bigger. Connect each other, work together. Everybody is friends. We work together. We trust each other. But today, so many kinds of, all of the people access internet. Some people you cannot trust them. Some people, most people is good, but some people is not good, right? But concurrent internet cannot provide their trust access. This is a big challenge. Third one is high performance. The people always hope internet fast and fast. So free access, right? So this is a big challenge. We need a very high speed routers, a very high speed access devices. So this is sort of challenges. For many challenges, how to solve the challenges, how to meet the challenges. So we have to focus internet architecture. Internet architecture is the core internet technologies. You want to get the best internet, you have to involve deeply to internet architecture. So this is the only way to promote internet better than before. But about 10 years ago, some people suggest or propose design new networking to replace concrete internet, use some clean state model to replace concrete internet. But 10 years passed, but they did not get results. So concrete internet still going, still best than before. It's a two-way. One way is the revolution, another way is the evolution. Just to make internet better. Because people need a very reliable internet to go in. You can make internet better, but you cannot use another, totally use another new networking. This is very dangerous, sometimes dangerous, right? So concrete internet is too big. Internet is a very strange issue, strange things. Human design, this networking, but you never know what happened in the future. This is interesting. So far, so many surprise applications happen. Before, probably 20 years ago, but 10 years ago, you never think this happened. In China, I can give you an example. Several things, like such as payment methods. Right now, so many Chinese people, they don't bring cash. They don't bring cars. The credit cards, the debit card, they never use cash You just use cell phone. You can payment, no card, no cash, the payment. Very convenient, very useful. You never think about this happen before. This is a very success application of the internet. Another surprise is online shopping. Before, we always believed that we need to go to physical shopper. You can see something, you can buy something, right? But right now, so many young people, they just buy something online. They never go to a physical shop. They select, they ask people deliver to the home, to the office. Particularly in China, we have very cheap delivery fee. United States, I don't know, I heard sometimes very expensive, but take a lot of time. But in China, 24 hours, you can go everywhere in China. The big country, but the 24 hours you can go deliver something to everywhere. It's believable before.